Welcome to another video review, friends. Pixel 2 and Pixel 2 XL are probably the best Android phone out there, but the Pixel 2 has a huge bezel, while the XL have started mostly with a series of issues at launch, which has kept most of its buyers at bay. Now, close to 3 months after using it, and considering mostly all the issues like no saturated color, unresponsive edges, screen burning, microphone gain issues, etc. are all fixed, with the only thing remaining is the blue shift, which I would say is present in almost most of the AMOLED display, the Pixel 2 XL is turning out to be a great option. Especially with the recent price drop in sale window, this is the closest to the iPhone of the Android world, and with that being said, let's take a quick review of this device made by Google. Out of the box, the Pixel 2 XL design are definitely modern, neat, and it will appeal to most of the users. With the combination of coated aluminium back and glossy finish, the feel of the phone is great in hands. Though it has a huge display, but the 18:9 aspect ratio and narrow bezel means you can hold it comfortably in your hands. Definitely the bezels are a little bigger at top and bottom if you compare it with other 18:9 phones, but what you get here is an amazing front firing speakers, which are awesome and don't block your audio when you hold it normally while playing games or consuming media. Other hardware of the phone is also good. Buttons are clicky, fingerprint scanner is definitely one of the fastest out there and accurately does the job all the time. But there are other areas which is not perfect, like no headphone jack. After making fun of Apple in previous year, they removed the headphone jack this time. Also, they don't pack any USB-C headphone or Bluetooth headphone in the box. Do note it is just IP67 rated, which is lower than the Samsung's offering of IP68. Anyway, you can always use it in rain and definitely it will survive the genuine water drops. There is this squeeze feature in this phone to activate Google Assistant. This is definitely a welcome feature and will make people use the Google Assistant more. Best thing, it works perfectly in Indian accent also. So you can easily check your calendar, open apps, set alarms and reminders, and do the random queries effortlessly. Performance of the phone is great with the Oreo update to the latest security patch always. The standard 4GB RAM and Snapdragon 835 processor does a great job. Though it is considered pure Android device, but the Pixel does pack some decent feature on top of the raw Android. Like the redesigned setting apps is great, multitasking window is faster, and the picture-in-picture mode is very cool implementation. Notification dots give you a great feature to read through your notifications without opening the app. There is also a very cool little feature of Now Playing. It does an amazing job of identifying any song playing around you. Best part, it works totally offline and does not use your internet. It does an amazing job in identifying Indian music, whether it is the recent one or the melodies from the past. The app drawer is also implemented well. Based on your wallpaper, it gives you a black or white background, which is a neat feature. Other than that, it also has an always-on display, which gives you a meaningful information all the time without you needing to unlock the device. Another feature packed in this device is Google Lens. It does a very decent job in finding details in any picture you scan and provides you relevant link to the searched image. This, to be said, is cool when it does work, but there are times when it simply fails to identify anything. But to be honest, to be able to save a phone number from a picture is a great feature to have. The phone has a great battery life too. In normal day of use, you will get around 5 to 6 hours of screen on time, which means you can get through a complete day without any issue. There is also fast charging supported here, but do note that there is no wireless charging due to its metal design. Now, let's talk about the best feature of this phone, which the whole world is talking about. It is the camera. With a single primary lens of 12 megapixel and f1.8, which is both optically and electronically stabilized, it does a way better job than any of the competition which uses dual lens to do the same thing. The Google image processing software does a wonderful job in creating some of the great image all the time. This is simply the best camera you can get in a smartphone right now. The picture it takes in low light are incredible and blows the competition right away. Though it do not provide a robust manual mode like other device, but it does an amazing job by itself and you just need to point and shoot. The autofocus is great, the HDR implementation is great, sharpness is great, contrast is great, and the color accuracy is great too. It takes a second to process the image, and be rest assured, with this phone at your hands, you will be on top of your Instagram and Facebook game for years to come. The selfie camera is great too. The 8 megapixel front camera takes an amazing picture, and you do get your portrait shots in the front camera too. Another cool feature added to the camera is the inbuilt AR support. There are many AR stickers which you can drop it in your photo or video to make it stand out. It definitely looks cool, and many people have asked me on whether the character was some real toy I got. This is really fun thanks to a separate image processor chip included in the phone from Google. To encourage you to take even more and more photos, Google is providing you with a huge unlimited photo and video storage for the next 3 years. Where the competition charges you huge money for this type of service, you not only get to store unlimited pictures, but you can do that in the highest resolution, and even you can store 4K videos. To be absolutely honest, friends, this phone is the closest you can get to having a perfect phone. Buy this and you will be getting guaranteed Android updates for the next 3 years, along with loads of other features which I have already mentioned. So friends, if you can get past the display issue, which according to me is definitely not a deal breaker, I suggest if this phone is in your budget, then you can go for it. I hope you enjoyed the video and the contents. If so, then definitely hit the like button and subscribe to this channel for more content like this. For any questions and queries, feel free to hit me up in Twitter account, and until next time, stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you.